What's up? John Vanderslice, White Wilderness.
Hey, everybody. Anthony Fantano here, the internet's busiest music nerd, and we're going to embark upon an album review. So batten up the hatches and hop on board and I hate boats. Before we get into this review on theneedledrop.com right now, there's a track review of a song from the new Talib Kweli album, Gutter Rainbows, and download the entire new Dumbo Gets Mad album. Yes. It is out. Digitally. Mm-hmm. So now that that LP is out, I think y'all know what tomorrow's review is gonna be. Wink, wink, wink. But first, let's discuss this. John Vanderslice is a Florida singer-songwriter, and this is his new LP, White Wilderness. And it features the Magic Magic Orchestra, which is a California collective of classically trained musicians led by director Mina Choi. And this thing is definitely a change of pace for John, especially when you compare it to his last album, which had good songs on it, but really didn't have any kind of sounds or production tricks that you wouldn't expect on a singer-songwriter LP. What makes White Wilderness interesting, with the addition of the orchestra, is that it was recorded live and sounds like it is virtually devoid of any and all post-production. So when you hear the strings swelling underneath John's voice, it's happening right then, right there. And it's really added this great in-the-moment feel to the album. More often than not, when a lot of arrangements are added to a song, added to an LP, it sort of tends to choke off the emotion of the track, maybe get between the singer and the listener, but I wouldn't say that's the case here. More often than not, the Magic Magic Orchestra actually adds a new level of emotion and interaction to these songs. Though I will admit, one of the best songs here, After It Ends, features no extra instrumentation whatsoever. But this thing is pretty much just piano, acoustic guitar, woodwinds, brass, strings, percussion, just a nice piece of modern Baroque pop. But despite the beauty of the instrumentation and some of the affecting images that John pulls together in his lyrics, like the Gaza Strip, or Latchkey Kids, or Glass Bottom Boats, I just don't find the songwriting as interesting as I do the instrumentation. When John loses my attention, I pretty much just gravitate toward whatever's going on in the arrangements, which I would say is a bad thing if the arrangements weren't so dang good. Plus, if somebody were to come up to me and say, "Anthony, this is unoriginal, this is run-of-the-mill," I wouldn't argue. The thing is, we've heard this setup before. We've been here. This is definitely new territory for John Vanderslice, and territory his fans will probably love to hear him go in, but when we're talking about the bigger picture of things, what this album may sound like to an outsider, this LP may come up like a less epic, less dynamic version of some of Sufjan Stevens' more praised albums. But overall, I'm liking it. It's just over 30 minutes. It does not overstay its welcome. It's full of intricate and beautiful acoustic instrumentation and has a really vibrant live execution. Still, overall, this album is just kind of a crush for me. Not loving it, liking it, crushing on it, like, ooh, that album's hot, but I'm still walking the other direction. Right now I'm like a strong 6 on this, but what do you guys think about this album? Is this a shocking change of pace for John Vanderslice? Is this a mammoth of a singer-songwriter album? And what do you think about arrangements surrounding songs? What does adding a ton of strings, piano, horns, woodwinds actually do to a track? Help it or hurt it, in your opinion? Anthony Fantano, John Vanderslice, and the Magic Magic Orchestra, White Wilderness, forever.